Mr. Jani, what are the future growth prospects of the express industry? How fast is it growing now?
Well, the industry has grown last year at about 35%. But with the liberalization and the way the industrialization going on, the industry should grow at a much higher rate than probably 35.
And you think the competition is also hotting up?
Well, yes. It always happens in a developing economy. If you see an opportunity, naturally people will like to get into that business, and there's nothing wrong in it.
Okay. And we find that a lot of the big courier companies are becoming high-tech. They're offering modern facilities. Is it also a result of the competition?
Well, let me take it back here to the history that we guys in the courier industry set together a few years before, and we redefined our business. And it was a process of real re-engineering where we called ourselves now as an express company. We do much more than courier, you know. Courier is part of our activity, but we are in warehousing, we are in logistic business, and information technology is an important tool to cover up what we are doing today. Let me put it this way, company like us in Blue Dart, we have a philosophy that 50% of our business is pickup, delivery and transportation, and 50% business is information. And we believe information is economics and economics is information. So that's where we are.
1 minute, just stop. Is the sound disturbed?
One second. You want
yeah.
A walkie-talkie
also? Yeah, you can catch hold of this walkie-talkie. Yeah,
that's nice.
Yeah, that's nice. You can talk to us with the walkie-talkie in your hand.
Right.
Okay, the third question is, what is the idea of courier companies offering warehouse facilities?
See, when the economy goes and thrive towards the industrialization, and with the GDP growing the way it is growing today in the economy, you need a product cycle time which is much faster. And when you have a shorter product cycle time, you need an effective logistic to deliver your product to the ultimate consumer. All of us, what we are doing in terms of the business logistic services is reduce your inventory, shorten your transportation time, and give product to the ultimate consumer in the shortest period. It saves in terms of cost for you, it makes your product cycle faster, and you can do innovation in terms of your product. So you become part of the production, actually.
What are the corporate houses which are using your facilities?
Well, we have Titan Watches, which is using our facility. We have Wipro, we have Tata IBM. I can name more and more and more. I mean, it's endless list, you know, and everyone is asking today at this kind of services.
And there is a thing, you see, the private courier services are costlier than the government courier service speed post. Do you think that is justified?
It is. Company like ours has spent close to something like 9 crore rupees only on computerization till today. And we have got plans to put in more money in computerization. Company like ours has spent 1.4 crore on training, you know, to train our people. And all these adds up. What we are selling primarily is reliability and an information. If you have a packet which is being picked up from your place, not delivered on time or not delivered properly, or if you do not have the information back to you when it is going to be delivered or when it was delivered, it doesn't make sense to pay for the money for the services what we offer. You might as well go for a ordinary universal postal service, which is much cheaper even than speed post.
But aren't you worried that some of the business might go to speed post because of the cheaper
fare? Oh, there is enough for everyone in the game, you know. I mean, everyone would be happy to have that.
How helpful is it to have international tie-ups?
Well, what happens vis-a-vis the international, you get the reach. Company like ours, who has a tie with Federal Express, who is world's largest air express company, has got their own planes, has got network in more than 180 countries, and has a communication, you know, network set up in all these countries. It really gives you a reach, you know, and that's very important with the today's globalization scheme.
Do you foresee airlines getting into express service?
Well, worldwide, the airlines have tried to getting into so-called express business. But, you know, our partner Federal Express and the other integrators in the world has got their own ground transportation, has got their own air transportation, has got their own setup all around, and which gives a single window service to the customer, and which is very vital in our kind of trade, whereby, you know, a customer has to look at only one agency. Whereby, take classic case of an international airline who is more on passenger. The core business is to serve passenger. For them, this kind of services are, you know, ad hoc and adding into the revenue. It's not their core business. And that's the basic difference.
And what is the latest technology you're offering?
Well, what we have typically in Blue Dot, we have this information technology which we initiated in our company about 3-4 years before. We have been operating on a private largest email network in the country dedicated to the company people. We have about 2,000 people who are on email. Every parcel has been traced and tracked. We were, you know, currently are depending on the territorial lines. We are moving into VSAT lines, where the tracking would become much faster. We have given computer connections to our customer. Our customer can trace and track the shipment directly from their office. They don't need to call us. We have got a power voice, whereby the computer assist voice will give you all the information on the computer, where your package is, and the other aspect of the services.
Do you think that the government discriminates speed post and the private courier services?
Well, the Indian Post Act, which is 100 years old almost, needs an amendment. This act needs to recognize the express industry as a part of system. We need an equal rights as been given to the speed post in terms of carrying letters or in terms of carriage as carried by speed post. Our demand is very simple, that let consumer decide what he wants to use, whether speed post, ordinary post, or a private express company. We had a discussion with the postal authorities. Our discussion are going in a right way. The speed post and us have agreed to work out a situation where there is place for everyone. And I'm very hopeful with the economic reforms and where the Indian government going right now, that we will be able to derive a situation where speed post and all of us can be on the same platform.
Are you also unhappy about the fact that the parcels less than 200 grams are out of bounds for?
Well, we have already conveyed our strong objection to that. We are not going to accept the situation that below 200 gram we cannot carry it. It is totally unacceptable to us. Post department also has realized our situation, whereby 98% of document which we carry today are around 60 grams. And it amounts to a virtual monopoly for the post. Post have realized this situation, and I hope the new formula which post has agreed to create with us would take care of it.
What's your clientele now, the kind of target audience you have?
So you must understand the way our the tariff structure the express company has, definitely the business clients are the major chunk of our customer. We have students who are our customer who wants to send their applications also. We have few, domestic people who want to send their business documents are also our customer. The major chunk comes from the business establishments, the bankers, the finance institution, shipping companies, exporters, and so on.
So will you be targeting only at the premium segment?
Well, the way our charges are, that premium segment would be our customer all time. And all of us have put in money in high tech, all of us have put money in training, and now the next war is going to be up in the sky. So definitely our customers would be primarily would be in business establishments.
One last question, what is the industry turnover? What is the growth,
well, the
size of the market?
Well, should this year aim about 400 crore plus. I'm talking only organized express company who are member of our Express Industry Council of India.
And final question, will you also be using satellite technology in the future?
Well, as I mentioned to you, we are going over VSAT. As far as our international communication is concerned, we are already using VSNL satellite technology. And now we want to do the same thing in the domestic also. So definitely we'll be using it.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.